Imagine living your entire life carrying heavy loads on your back, dragging things through the road, thinking, well, that's just how it is. You never question it, because why would you? That's just how everyone does it, right? Then one day, you see this round thing. Someone's taken a large log, cut it into circles, and suddenly everything changes. Now, I know comparing a Neovim plugin to the invention of the wheel might sound a bit dramatic, just a bit, but hear me out. For over 7 years, I've been pimping my Vim config, the Neovim, and as we all like to say, it's a journey on its own. But every once in a while, you come across a plugin that doesn't only move the needle, it pushes it all the way. I thought MINI.NVIM was the largest set of small utilities like these, and I even made a recent video covering it, check it above. But then MINI.NVIM referred to MINI.NVIM, and just as I started taking a closer look at it, its author Evgeny went live on VimConf and beautifully presented some of his creations. You don't have to show me much beyond new text objects in Neovim to get me hooked, but MINI.NVIM does way, way more than that. It comes with operators, visual, Vim pairs, Vim impaired, it covers so many plugins. And about moving the needle, MINI.NVIM pushed mine and it did a 360. In other words, MINI.NVIM was the biggest recent upgrade to how I work with Neovim, and this deserves an apology even before starting out. MINI is actually quite the contrary, it's maxi, and I wouldn't be able to cover it all in one go without doing a huge disservice to it. So these are my personal picks combined with Evgeny, its creator, and with that in mind, let's get into it. With close to 6,000 stars on GitHub, MINI.NVIM is not a new project by any means. What's impressive though is the sheer number of MINI modules. Each can and should be used in conjunction with others, or as a standalone module, your choice. From text objects through code manipulation, hints, fuzzy pickers, a file manager, and Git essentials, it's all there. And if you're thinking, well, this guy is going to fight with TPOPE and Falk, you have a point. Installing is rather easy, like any other plugin, especially if you're taking it all. And before getting into what it can do, I highly recommend listening to Evgeny, the creator of MINI.NVIM, speaking on VimConf earlier this month. So with Neovim fired up, I'm adding MINI.NVIM to Lazy, making sure I'm working with the latest stable version as per the recommendations. Let's let Lazy do its thing, and as a side note, I'll just say how refreshing it is to see Lazy not hitting a wall of permission issues like I had through the past few months using Nix's home manager, more on that story in the video above. Right, installation is ready, I'll add plugins.mini to my ini.lua file and mini.lua file itself under my plugins directory. Everything can be found on my .files repo on GitHub, so don't worry. Now, there are a bunch of MINI modules as you can see here, but let's not get ahead of ourselves. The first, and in my eyes, one of the foundations of MINI is AI. And no, not that AI. Isn't it refreshing to hear of an AI that is addressing around and inside text objects? Like all other MINI modules, AI comes with its own README, features list, a small demo, and instructions. You'd probably not be surprised to hear that MINI has its own package manager called MINI.deps. I won't be using it in this video as I didn't see a good enough reason, and since my lazy already holds the entire library, all that's left is to require the module and call it setup method. You probably already know that you can select around backtick with VA backtick. The same naturally works with single quotes and double quotes. But what if we didn't have to search for the backtick or a single quote or double ones? What if I could just say VAQ and mark around the next quote, regardless of what they are? Well, with MINI AI we can. I can also delete inside the next quote in my way, but wait, it's dot repeatable, so I can keep hitting dot to keep clearing the quote surrounded text in my way regardless of how it's wrapped. Neovim keeps looking at the text in my way, so if I push the visual mark further, I'll just hit the one that comes along, even if it's 20 lines below. Keep this one in mind that it's super handy whether you're using MINI or not. While Q stands for quotes, B stands for brackets, and just like that, we can visually grab text around brackets with VAB. And it's aware enough to move from the inside out and then follow to the outer scope. Square brackets first, then the round ones, and then the curly braces. So these are just basic text objects. Check out this thing as it goes even deeper. The tree-sitter text object lets you interact with functions, around, in, etc. It also partially knows how to interact with function attributes, but MINI AI takes it to the next level. Sadly, when it comes to Golang's ability to squeeze multiple attributes with the same type, MINI addresses them as the same one, but I'll manage. And as with other objects, things can be applied in an object, which leaves the comma in this instance, or around an object, which here removes the separator as well. Mini AI knows beyond just these. It can also detect digits. So having 6 wrapping whatever lines of text between two instances, I can VI6 to visually mark everything between them. And as always, around them works too, and any action we send. So if you ever want to grab all the text between two instances of 6 and change their case, well, you can. Like digits, spaces are also recognized as a valid character to work with. Selecting the text between two spaces or around them can be very useful at times. Now, a quick reminder, in many cases, Mini AI and the TreeSitter text objects can create conflicts. You won't see errors, but they just won't perform as you'd expect, so I prefer to go ahead and disable TreeSitter's text objects altogether if I'm taking Mini AI over it. Another piece of magic Mini brings to the table is the concept of next and last. You can use them with any operation, telling the editor whether you want to actually go forward in your next section or actually find the previous instance. Here, for example, standing with a cursor between some and thing, I can tell it to VANQ to mark around the next quotes. This is similar to doing it without N, however, the same with L, for last wraps the previous instance around the word some. Similarly, I can find the next brackets to wrap, throwing me 30 lines down, and I can go back to visually marking the previous bracketed line with VALB like so. Yet another simple but genius, small and useful concept of text motions. The order in which Mini AI wraps everything is as follows. Wrapping around the brackets that are next to my cursor, whether on the same line or not, it will tap into the object around them. However, wrapping a nested object, like here with VAB, and then AB around the next brackets, will move to the next in line and so on. Then it'll find the surrounding brackets, i.e. the brackets around the current line, and then going to the next one outside. Knowing this makes it easier to understand how Mini AI behaves and when it chooses to do things, and can also save you time of yet another motion in Neovim. Since we're already in the surrounding game, the next Mini module I really think you should know is Mini Surround. If you're thinking to yourself, I have the famous T-Pop's Vim Surround, you're absolutely right. So here I am commenting it out, which, by the way, removing a T-Pop plugin from your setup feels like a blasphemy of some sort. In any case, Mini can take over this functionality as well. But it's not only saving a line from my lazy config, which is very nice, don't get me wrong, but check this out. Having the ability to wrap around the word with pretty much anything isn't new, but as with other modules, Mini Surround plays nice with Mini AI, so I can surround around brackets. Now keep in mind the defaults are slightly different, and more natural actually, if you ask me. So SAWB means surround add, then W for word and B for brackets. It really can't get any simpler than that, especially when previously I had to do something like YSW and closing bracket. Naturally, the same works with Q for quotes and, of course, dot repeatable. I just love it when things work in a sensible way that also integrates with one another. Just like adding, we can delete surrounding wrappers with SD and the object. In our case, we can use Q for quotes, so SDQ and, of course, repeat. But wait, it gets even better. If I have a word and I intend to make it a function and forgot the function call for whatever reason, I can use surround to wrap it with whatever I want. With surround add in word or SAIW and then F for function, we get a function name input that takes anything. Just using func plainly will surround my word with that. But this is not proper Go code, so let's do the same and this time add func and a name. And there you have it. Once we have the function, it's immediately recognized, so we can start using attribute text objects to select, delete, or replace them. Surround becomes very useful for me personally when using markdown formatting, like adding underscores to a word. Now, here's something I didn't like about it, which I'm not sure whether a bug, something missed, or intended behavior, but standing inside a word and trying to wrap around it for some reason always addresses the cursor as the starting point. Please comment if you know why. So up until this point, we've been doing pretty standard things, slight improvements, maybe nicer configurations, but you want to check out MINI operators, the lesser known module of MINI. Now, just before getting started, MINI operator uses G as its key, so things like the default GR for go to reference of the LSP can conflict. For now, I took Evgeny's advice by preceding that with a leader key to fix the issue. With that out of the way, we can start playing around with operators. One thing I always found myself fighting with, and actually tried complicating mappings for, is replacing another word with some text. While I usually go for Yankin word and then go to the next word and VAW to select it, followed by paste, with operators I can send a replace motion, meaning GRIW to replace in the current word with what's held in the register. While this isn't incredibly useful in this instance, it can be done on every other object introduced by MINI AI, and it's not repeatable. Moreover, it adds some motions that are a tiny bit nicer. For example, the famous YYP to duplicate a line is not ideal in a QWERTY keyboard, and it can be used with GRR, which is not only nicer, but requires less reach and improves the motion. Not only that, GRR adheres to indentation, something you don't get with the default command. So here, GRR will keep replacing the line, but place it in the exact indentation level as its predecessor. We're already duplicating, so let's use the duplication operator, or as MINI calls it, multiply. GMIW will multiply, meaning duplicate the word. You can repeat it and use it with text objects like GMIB to multiply inside brackets, or A around them. GMM will duplicate a line, creating another nicer keyboard role for line duplication. Another super useful operator is X to exchange. This one works by running it twice on the source and then the target. So GXIW to mark the first word, which is then marked in blue, followed by GXIW again to replace it with the next word. Now, yes, you can use dot instead of repeating it. Still works in pairs, but easier to handle. GXX will work on a full line, which is just like DDP, but with indentation awareness. Another edge case operator is the ability to evaluate contents of something. So 2 plus 2, surrounded by brackets, can be evaluated to 4 using G equal IB to compute in brackets. Now, bear in mind this is the Lua interpreter, so while math calculations work, entire Lua line can be fed into it as well, like getting a list of buffers from Vim's API. MINI operator can sort words and numbers in paragraph or an object, and while it is nice, I don't see a huge benefit over selecting an area and sending it to the sort CLI or just use Vim's built-in, but nevertheless, it's there. Yet another MINI module is Pairs, and another plugin you can happily scratch off your plugins list. I don't know if you can start seeing the power of MINI that lets you add it and replace a bunch of other plugins while improving them, so here's my beloved Pairs, brackets and quotes, surrounded, nested, however you want it. Wait, did I say brackets again? So yeah, another MINI module, Bracketed. You know how you can use your brackets to go to the next or previous diagnostic error or change or whatever you have configured? Well, MINI Bracketed pushes even these boundaries and saves me even lines of config like traveling between diagnostics configured in my LSP plugin. So while I can go back and forth between errors, I can now switch between buffers simply by running open square bracket or close to go to the previous or next buffer. I can do the same with splits by hitting W to switch between windows. Y will literally find the next line you yanked, and there's more, comments, conflicts, jump list entries, even undo statements. Now, we've been through a lot, so before wrapping things up, I want to show you one gem I saved for last, which was how I found MINI in the first place. Remember I told you I was referred to it by snacks? Well, it referred to a config file within MINI files, one of the best MINI modules in my opinion. If you like OilNVIM, or finding yourself hacking files creation or renaming by splitting a TMux screen, sending commands through Vim, or God forbid use a file tree for that, MINI files makes things so much easier to deal with. Open it, like so, or map it however you like, then you get an easy to traverse tree of files. Wanna rename something? Just rename it. Yeah, CW to change a word and type your name. Want another file? Open a new line and create it. Delete a file? You guessed it. DD, the line is gone and the file is gone with it. To actualize the changes, hit equal and you'll get an approval prompt listing the changes you're about to make to the file system. Let's make sure it did in fact did what it said and everything looks in order. I'd love to stay and show you around MINI and its other modules, but I'll leave something for you to find out or the comment section if you think that I missed something and needs to be covered in other videos. In the meantime, I'll point out MINI Jump 2D, letting you have the Vimium experience by using tags to jump around code bits. I personally am not a big fan, as I believe this makes me a lazy Vim user and by that, gradually, a slower Vim user, which I'm not sold on. You might also try Animate to make motions a tiny bit more pleasant. Again, not my style, but it's there. You have Mini Peak that can be your next speaker manager, and while I'm not sending my beloved telescope, I think you can get the idea. MINI does it all. There is an icon provider and a notifier. I mean, it's not far from being declared as yet another Neovim distro. MINI.NVIM can be a bit much, and like any great platform, the choice paradox kicks in and it's hard to find anything with so many choices around. I'd stick to the basics, the core essentials that really move the needle, and leave the rest for later if you're really into them. My picks are all in this video and I'd be really happy to hear your thoughts. However, if you're just starting out or looking to tidy up your config, here's me going through my complete setup from scratch. Thank you for watching and I'll see you on the next one.